네, 안녕하세요. 좌장을 맡은 서울대학교 조철현입니다. 오영근 교수님의 한국과학상 수상기념 특별 강연에 좌장을 맡게 되어 영광입니다. 오영근 교수님은 사교기하학과 관련 분야에 많은 뛰어난 업적을 남기셨습니다. 그래서 특히 라그랑장 플로우 이론에 대해서는 라그랑장 플로우 이론의 아버지라고 불리셔도 될 만큼 이론의 토대에서부터 시작해서 응용까지 많은 중요한 업적을 남기셨습니다. 이러한 라그랑장 플로우 이론은 사교 위상수학뿐만 아니라 거울대칭 가설의 핵심적인 이론적인 기법으로 사용되고 있습니다. 오윤근 교수님의 양력을 간단히 말씀드리겠습니다. 서울대학교를 83년도 학부 졸업하셨고요. UC 버클리 에서 88년도 박사 학위를 받으셨습니다. 2013년까지 위스콘신 대학교에서 교수로 재직하시다가 귀국하셔서 IBS CGP 연구소 연구단장님과 포스텍 수학과 교수님으로 재직 중이십니다. 2000년 젊은 수학자상을 수상하셨고요. 마드리드 세계 수학자 대회 기하학 분야 초청 연사로 선정되셨습니다. 2012년 경암상을 수상하셨고요. 이번에 2019년 한국과학상을 수상하셨습니다. 양력에 대한 소개는 이것으로 마치겠습니다. 오늘 강연 주제는 그롬오프 위튼 플로우 이론과 심플렉틱 토폴로지입니다.
예, 우리 소개해 주신 우리 조철은 교수님한테 감사드리고요. 저 강의는 영어로 하겠습니다. 예, 제가 오늘 So I'm going to talk about Kronhoff Witten flow theory and symplectic topology in the historical context. This is the outline of my lectures, symplectic geometry before 1980s and advent of symplectic topology in 1980s and Kronhoff-Witten flow theory and mirror symmetry and application to symplectic topology. So let me start with where this symplectic geometry start. It comes from Hamiltonian mechanics. So Hamilton's mechanics is governed by Hamilton's equation in classical. And one of the important operations in Hamiltonian mechanics is so-called the Poisson bracket. So that is defined in this way for given two functions H and F, and the bracket is defined in this explicit form in physics literature. And this happens on the so-called phase space, that is the six-dimensional Euclidean space, and there are dual pairs of coordinates. And it turns out the geometric structure governing this Poisson algebra is this so-called symplectic structure. So this is the beginning of a symplectic geometry. And the importance of Hamiltonian mechanics is provides so-called quantization, which is the transition from classical mechanics to quantum mechanics. It maps a function H to an operator on a Hilbert space, which turns this Poisson bracket to the commutator bracket. Such a process is in mathematics is called quantization. And before Gromov's advent of pseudo-Lorentz curves in 1980s, symplectic geometry played an important role as the language in geometrizing the aforementioned quantization-like process in mathematics, such as geometrical theory of linear partial differential operator, such as in micro-local analysis. And it also arises in the group representation theory and even in number theory. And this is the classical analog to Heisenberg's uncertainty principles, the question asked by Arnold and Gromov in 1960s. The question is, does there exist a canonical transformations, which is now called the Hamiltonian diffeomorphisms, squeezing a ball round ball of radius capital R into the cylinder over two-dimensional disk of radius small r times R4. especially when the small radius is r is smaller than this capital R. So this is the picture. So important point here is that this two-dimensional plane is this Q1 P1 plane. This is plane of conjugate coordinate. And Gromov proved in 1985 this is impossible unless this capital R, the radius of this ball is smaller than the radius of this cylinder. When this happens, the embedding is trivial by rigid motion. But the point is that if the radius of this round ball is greater than the radius of this cylinder, then it's impossible. Even though the ball of round ball has finite area, but the cylinder has infinite area. And Gromov used the machinery of so-called analytic machinery of pseudo-holomorphic curves to prove these non-squeezing theorems. And the importance of this non-squeezing theorem is to give the complete proof of this Eliasberg and Gromov's Cicero rigidity theorems, which is beginning of so-called simplex topology. And this, the pseudo-holomorphic curves in simplex geometry is some almost a complex generalization of holomorphic curves. The holomorphic curves is used in several complex variables in algebraic geometry a lot, as the Professor Kang Tae Kim explained in the previous lectures. And the generalizations happens by considering almost the non-integrable, almost complex structure J. The first equation in this screen is just the Cauchy-Riemann equation. And then it turns out this equation can be combined or twisted by the Hamiltonian dynamics by perturbing the equation by this Hamiltonian vector fields. The second equation is precisely the equation, this Andreas Floh used in his definition of so-called Floh homology. And one of the important thing about this Floh homologies in the point of simplex topologies is enables us to define some so-called spectral invariance. And by now, this is the most effective way of constructing so-called simplex capacity, which was used in Gromov's non-squeezing theorems. And the spectral invariance was in the Lagrangian version, spectral invariance was constructed by myself in 1997, and then the Hamiltonian version is in 2005. And these are the critical values of classical action functionals. And the pseudo-holomorphic curve turns out to be equivalent to so-called some object Witten considered in nonlinear sigma models. These are the correspondents. Gromov's pseudo-holomorphic curves corresponds to Witten's so-called nonlinear sigma models. And the Riemann surface sigma with no boundary corresponds to closed string theories. And Riemann surface sigma with the boundary is the object considered in open string theories. And the Lagrangian submanifold is a version of so-called D-brain, we call Lagrangian D-brain. The importance of Lagrangian submanifolds was indicated by the Weinstein, who coined this so-called symplectic creed. But the point is that everything in symplectic topology should be something about Lagrangian submanifold. So a systematic study of an existent result of the solutions of these Cauchy-Riemann equations can be carried out by defining some counting invariants. That's now called Gromov-Witten invariant. And this whole thing can be framed in the framework of two-dimensional open-closed topological quantum field theories. According to the physicist Kellen Lazaroyu, who was one of our member in CGP, the two-dimensional open-closed topological quantum field theories is mathematically equivalent to the following data. The A, that's commutative Frobenius algebra, corresponding to the closed sector in this topological quantum field theories. And then the script C, this is so-called Calabi-Yau categories, that corresponds to the open sector. And then the existence of bulk boundary map, which relates this closed sector and open sector. The explicit expression of this bulk boundary map is given as follows. And this is the sort of pictorial description of bulk boundary map. And this parabola-like object is the, just the disk. And then you put a lot of insertion in the interior, that's on the left-hand side, and then the insertion on the boundaries, and then this whole picture provides some information of this bulk boundary map. You can think of this is a disk instanton probe of the Lagrangian brain in this background space of symplectic manifold. And this topological quantum field theory has two sides. One is A model, which I'm going to talk about. This is nothing but the Gromov-Witten flow theory. It's a, okay, and the symplectic manifold. So it consists of open sector, which is the Fukaya category. And Fukaya category is basically the category consisting of whose objects are Lagrangian brains and morphisms of flow complex or flow homologies. This flow homology can be regarded as some way of encoding the long-range interaction between the Lagrangian brains. The problem is this open sector has anomaly. In other words, the M1 square may not be zero. On the other hand, closed sector is the corresponds to quantum cohomologies. It does not carry any anomaly. So to handle the open sector, we need to find a way of handling this anomaly. And this is exactly the so-called deformation, the boundary deformation. And so here is the so you need to look at some object for which you can somehow handle this anomaly. So this is the notion of weakly unobstructed Lagrangian sum manifold, with Fukaya, myself, and Ota and Ono introduced. And the precise mathematical definition involves so-called infinite structures. And it provides this infinite Maurer-Cardan equations, and this equation depends on this Lagrangian submanifolds. If this equation is in non-trivial solutions, then we call that Lagrangian submanifold is weakly unobstructed. And for those weakly unobstructed Lagrangian submanifolds, we can define this flow homologies. But the problem is that this flow homology is very hard to compute. So we introduced this notion of the potential functions. And this actually corresponds to the physicist's notion of Landau-Ginzburg potential functions in some way. And then to make the whole theory more flexible, we also want to deform this potential function by so-called bulk deformation. So this is the deformation that you obtain by insertion of the interior of the previous picture. And then you can deform this whole Fukaya category by such a bulk data. And then that will also lead to some bulk deformed Mauer-Kaldang modular space. And then this will also lead to the new notion of this unobstructed Lagrangian submanifolds. And this is the way how you deform the whole Fukuya category. And then you consider all those collections, and you organize this potential function, including this bulk data. And this gives rise to the so-called big disk potential functions. So now this is the function defined on the ambient the cohomology of ambient space and the cohomology of this Lagrangian, this submanifold. So we are going to restrict, if you restrict this whole story for the toric case, you can actually compute all these potential function and do some critical point theories. You can actually compute all those complicated define this flow cohomology by just doing some critical point theory of this Landau-Ginzburg potential functions. And then with this means of computations, we can apply this whole complicatedly defined this machineries to the concrete problems in symplectic topologies. That's what we did. So Fu's the deformed Lagrangian flow theory is a flexible general tool to probe symplectic topology of underlying symplectic manifolds. So this is the joint paper, spectral invariance with the bulk quasi-morphisms and Lagrangian flow theories. This is in there we provide a new construction of many symplectic so-called quasi-states and quasi-morphisms to Hamiltonian diffeomorphisms. And we also created new examples of symplectic manifolds, which admit uncountably many independent quasi-morphisms. And we also give a new construction of non-displaceable Lagrangian surfaces and Lagrangian intersection result in concrete examples. And these are what we want to, what are left in, to do in the future. So we want to extend our theorem to the level of mirror symmetry of higher residue pairing. And we want to investigate how the story changes for the general funnel manifold, such as partial flag manifolds. Some progresses have been made by Nishino, Nohara, Ueda, and Cho Kim, and myself by considering the integrable system called Galpin-Settlin system. And the one should try to describe the relationship between the Fukuya categories in the closed symplectic manifolds and their open counterpart, so-called wrapped Fukuya categories. So, thank you for your attention.
Yeah, 좋은 강의해 주신 오영근 교수님께 감사드립니다. 혹시 코멘트나 질문 있으신 분들 손을 들어주시면 감사하겠습니다. 네, 김상현 교수님 질문해 주시겠습니까?
저 들리시나요?
예. 예.
아, 예, 좋은 강연 감사합니다. 저 혹시 그 해밀토니안 그룹의 코지모르피즘을 연구하시는 어떤 모티베이션이 있나요? 아니면 혹시 해밀토니안 그룹의 호몰로지라든지 그런 데 대한 인포메이션을 줄 수가 있나요? 코지모르피즘을 공부하는 것이?
예. 그러니까 그 코지모르피즘이라는 게 그런 걸 좀 구체적으로 체계적으로 이제 연구하기 위한 하나의 툴로서 코아지모피즘이 사용될 수 있습니다. 그러니까 뭐 이 스펙트럴 인베리언트라는 게 지금 내가 지금 얘기한 그 스탠다드한 그런 플로우 호몰로제만 적용되는 게 아니고 임의의 모든 플로우 타입 호몰로제 테어리에 적용될 수가 있거든요. 이제 그렇게 되면은 이제 여러 가지 굉장히 강력한 테어럼들이 증명이 될 수가 있습니다.
네, 다른 질문이나 코멘트 있으시면 해주시겠습니까? 네, 제가 한 가지만 질문드려도 될까요?
예, 예. 네,
그 아까 그 새로운 플로우 이론의 결과로 다양한 쿼시 심플렉티 쿼시 스테이트를 찾으셨다고 하셨는데요. 그 이 심플렉티 쿼시 스테이트에 대한 소개를 간략하게 부탁드려도 될까요?
이제 뭐 퀀텀 미케닉스에서 이제 보통 뭐라 그러나 스테이트하고 뭐 업저버블 이런 커레스판던스 같은 거 얘기가 있는데 이게 이제 스테이트라는 게 어떻게 보면은 이제 수학적으로 얘기를 하면은 그냥 어떤 리니어 펑셔널이 그러니까 힐버트 스페이스 정의된 어떤 리니어 펑셔널인데 이거를 논리니어 컨텍스트에서 이제 제네럴라이즈를 할 수가 있거든요. 이제 어떤 퀀텀 미케닉스라는 걸 좀 더 이제 깊이 하다 보면은 그게 이제 소위 옛날에 아한스라는 수학자가 이제 일반적인 관점에서 쿼지 스테이트라는 걸 정의를 했는데 이제 그거를 이제 심플렉틱 지오메트리 컨텍스트에서 이제 연구를 한 사람이 엔토프하고 폴테로비치입니다. 그러니까 이제 그런 의미에서 이 뭔가 이 심플렉틱 토폴로지라는 게 상당히 좀 미스터리스한데 그러니까 그 안에 있는 이 미스터리를 이렇게 하나하나 이제 끄집어내는 단계에 있는데 이제 그렇게 하는 과정 속에서 이제 도출된 하나의 스트럭처입니다. 그러니까 예. 그 이상 네. 그러니까 어떤 뭐 심플렉틱 인베리언트라는 거를 체계적으로 이제 전체적으로 이렇게 오거나이즈 하나의 툴로서 생각하면 되겠습니다.
네, 좋은 답변 감사합니다. 혹시 더 다른 질문 있으신가요? 네, 그럼 이상으로 특별 초청 강연을 마치고 10분간 휴식 후 5시부터 정기총회 및 대한수학회상 시상식이 진행되겠습니다. 감사합니다.